a huge tick off our bucket list saw us flying to Arusha in Tanzania. From there, we met up with RA Safaris and visited Lake Tarangire, into the Serengeti, Ngorongoro Crater, Lake Manyara, back to Arusha and back home again.
So that is the way to Nairobi, the one which we drive before, and this one is go up to Dodoma.
Mr. Katia, so you can tell me what we're going to have for supper tonight.
Yeah, today we have some cucumber soup.
Cucumber soup?
Yes, like starter.
Yeah.
And also we have some spaghetti bolognese.
Oh, that sounds good. Yes. Spaghetti bolognese.
RA Safaris thoroughly spoilt us with their hospitality, and even though the camps were basic, our every need was catered for, and we did not have to lift a finger. The countryside outside of the parks were no reflection of what the national parks had to offer. Toyota Land Cruisers were the vehicle of choice, modified and kitted out especially to enhance the experience. Picnic sites have no dustbins and are spotless. Litter in, litter out. An after-lunch siesta was enjoyed by large and small. The variety of animals was amazing, and there were bird species that we had not seen before. Always something to see, never a dull moment. The Maasai may still wear traditional dress, but are fully urbanized. Having left Tarangire, we made our way to the Serengeti, and our first sighting was a pride of lions. A treasure treat with much more to come.
According for the Maasai, they chase them away because they used to eat their sheep and goats. So we don't have any more cheetah down in the crater.
Now the Maasai live there too?
The Maasai, they are not live here, down in the crater. They live on the rim of the crater. But before, they always live down here too.
The wide open space of the Ngorongoro was home to many animals. Every turn of the head, there was something to see.
So there's 5 miles in.
Ngorongoro Crater was a highlight, and then, all too soon, our trip ended at Lake Manyara.